plant growth hormones. Plant growth hormones, simply said as PGR. PGRs are phytochemicals. They are small, simple substances which promotes the plant growth. How many types of the plant growth hormones? The type of the plant growth hormones depends on two. One is growth promoting, another one is growth inhibiting. It means in plants, we see the five types of the plant hormones. They are also called as phytohormones, growth promoters, growth regulators. Five types of the plant hormones are identified. What are the five types? Auxins, gibberellins, cytokinins, abscisic acid, and ethylene. From where they are formed? What is the source to form phytochemicals? The phytochemicals are derivatives of different compounds, different precursor compounds. IAA, indole acetic acid, that is the auxin, that is the derivative of indole compound. Basically, for auxin production, the tryptophan compound is, tryptophan amino acid is most important. So, by using of indole compound, IAA is prepared. Adenine derivatives, phytohormones also adenine derivatives. Example are N6 purpuryl aminopurine as well as kinetin. Derivatives of carotenoids. So they are abscisic acid. Terpenes, derivatives of terpenes, gibberellic acid. Derivatives of gases, they are ethylene. It means from different sources, from different precursors, the phytohormones are formed. Where the phytohormones are formed? The phytohormones are formed where the active divisions are going on. But they produce very little concentration, but their activation is other than the production site. It means they are active at the catalytic site at different. For example, they are produced at the shoot tip or root tip, but they do not show impact on the shoot tip and root tip. They are translocated into the matured part. There they can work out. It means other than the generated site, they can work. PGRs. PGRs are divided into two types, growth promoters and growth inhibitors. Growth promoters means which cause the growth. What is growth? When you take the cell wise, the growth is cell division, cell elongation, cell maturation, fruits formation, flowers formation, seed formation, tropical movements. These all are including promotion, growth promotion. So such type of the conditions are promoted by the phytohormones. They are growth promoters. Basically, three are considered as growth promoters. They are auxins, gibberellins, and cytokinins. And another type is growth inhibitors. Growth inhibitors means they inhibit the growth. It means stress of abiotic origin. They come from stresses of abiotic and biotic origin. So, for example, you take the abscisic acid. When the concentration of abscisic acid is increasing, it means the plant is in condition of stress. To avoid stress, the plant can able to close the stomata in the presence of ABA concentration. It means the closure of stomata is depends onto the concentration of the ABA. In what condition the ABA is released means when the plant gets stress. It means lack of water, pathogenic effect, high temperature, humidity, high temperature and stress condition, environmental stress. On that conditions, the ABA is released. Generally, in water scarcity condition, the ABA released effectively. So, the concentration of ABA is increasing in the stomata means the stomata is capable for closing of itself. Okay, then through the stomata, the air do not transmitted. You see here, abscisic acid and ethylene both are considered as growth inhibitors. So they are formed at stresses of abiotic and biotic region, and they involved in dormancy and abscission. What is dormancy? Delayed seed germination is called dormancy. Delayed germination is called dormancy. Abscission, shedding of various parts of organism like shedding of leaves, shedding of fruits, like abscission. So these two are caused by abscisic acid, ethylene 2. So abscisic acid and ethylene 2 are considered as growth inhibitor. How they are identified? What is the history of plant growth hormones? The first identified plant growth hormone is auxins. The auxins are identified by scientists Charles Darwin and Francis Darwin. These two are conducted the experiments on photoperiodism. So for their experiment, they selected the plant, that is canary grass plant. So they use the part, that is coleoptile of canary grass. What is coleoptile? Coleoptile is the early formed protective sheet for upcoming tissues. Upcoming tissues, especially primule. Coleoptile is protective layer for primule. So on the coleoptile of canary grass, they conducted the experiments. So they seen the light responses of coleoptile of canary grasses when monochromatic light is passed. At the direction to the light, they show the responses, they grown the against side of the light, same side of the light. And later went, the scientist went, isolated the auxins. Auxins are isolated from the human urine also. Next, the scientist Kurosawa, he studied the disease, that is foolish seedling disease, that is also called as Bacana disease, that caused the disease in rice plant, rice seedling. The causative pathogen is Gibberella fusicuri. So the Gibberella fusicuri is the causative agent. So asexual stage of fusarium monoliformis. When Gibberella fusicuri sterile filtrates are infected with rice seedlings, the seedlings get neck dieback disease. It means they have the spikelet. The spikelet, the base of the spikelet is going to decompose because of effect of fungus. So that is called foolish seedling disease, also called as Bacani disease. That is caused by the fusarium monoliformis. The asexual stage of the fusarium monoliformis is Gibberella fusicuri. And later they isolated the white substance form, then they named as gibberellic acid. And next, F. Skoog, the scientist F. Skoog, when he cultured the tobacco stem in vitro cultivation, the callus is produced, the stem callus is produced, but the callus is not differentiated as organs. For organogenesis, he used the auxins. Along with auxins, he used yeast extract, coconut milk, and extract of vascular tissues that resulted to the organogenesis. He concluded that the material which caused the growth promotion and organogenesis that present in three of the compounds, yeast extracts, coconut milk, and extraction of vascular tissues. And later, Skoog and Miller crystallized the cytokinin, that is kinetin. Later, mid-90s, three scientists were independently isolated the inhibitors, inhibitor B, abscisin 2, dormin 2. They are three, the three are chemically analogous, chemically identical. Later, they concluded that these three are same compound, that is abscisic acid. Abscisic acid is anti-stress hormone. Next, causins. Causins absorb the release of volatile substances from ripened oranges that are promoting the ripening of bananas too. Later, the ethylene is extracted from ripened fruits. Then they clearly said that is one of the growth inhibitor. So like the history and discoveries are made of plant growth hormones.